Saloon Talk is brought to you by...
You are confident. You are radiant. Look good, feel great.
Okay, now we're going to get into our topic. Imagine you're a wife, and there's a wife, there's a husband. Wife decides to bring little sister from the village to stay with her so she can look after her. Situation happens. Husband decides to have sex with little sister, or little sister decides to have sex with husband. Who do we blame? Do we blame the little sister? Do we blame the wife? Do we blame the husband? Yeah? Or do we blame all? Eh? Who do you blame? When the husband decides to have sex with his wife's little sister, they stay under the same roof. Who do you blame? I blame you.
Me blame you too also.
You blame me. Me the wife, me the little sister.
You the wife.
I tell you, how do you blame me? Is it me who told you people come together and have sex?
Anyway, it's a little bit difficult, and it accords to the way how you behave when you're at home.
Or the way the wife behaves when she's at home?
That is it. The way how the wife behaves when she is at home. And the little sister, anyway.
What behavior are you talking about? The wife, what behavior are you talking about when she's not making juice?
I don't know even how I can explain this.
Yeah, please explain it.
With me, I cannot do that, sincerely speaking.
Yes, you cannot sleep with the little
sister. Yes, I cannot sleep with that.
No, but if a situation happens.
But if the situation happens, it cannot happen, sincerely. But the ladies must know, you have to respect your husband.
So if I don't respect the husband,
if you don't respect the husband, and if you don't do what the husband wants you to do,
The husband is free to go and like
things happen. Things
don't happen. Things happen when my button falls off. But when you sleep with my sister, that's a huge deal. But things happen. Who do you blame?
I blame the husband.
Why do you blame the husband?
Because if I'm the wife, yes, I trusted him. Since my sister's come home to help me out, maybe I'm pregnant, I've given birth. Yes. She has come to help me out with a baby, to cook for me. Uh-huh. So I blame the husband because since he decided to be with me, why would he go to my sister?
Maybe you're too busy. He said the behavior. What behavior are you talking about, Wama? Please be specific.
It was in a different direction, not in that direction.
Okay, which direction? Can you tell us what direction that is?
You know, it's like I'm saying, when she's saying that, she called the sister when she's sick or what like that.
Yes.
But there is a situation whereby you call your sister to come home.
And stay there.
And stay there.
And she's wearing her short skirts.
What like that?
And she's loitering around. And she's waking up things in your body.
That's when you see some guys. No.
Nalongo, please come join us. We'd like to know what you think. We need another woman on this, because who is representing the little sister here? Huh? Because I feel like this man has convinced this little sister. I don't think the little sister would just walk up and decided to tell the man, listen, lay down, I want this. Nalongo, who do you blame in this situation? First of all, welcome to the show.
Thank you.
Don't worry, Nalongo, I'll hold the mic for you.
Thank you so much. I want to act like a judge.
Okay.
Because everybody in this, how do you call it? In this situation,
yes,
is to blame.
Everybody? How do you blame the little sister? She's young, she's naive. She was convinced by this man to have sex with her. I mean, how do you blame me, the little sister?
Now, let's take parts.
Yes.
He's our husband.
Yes.
I am the wife.
Yes.
And that's our little sister.
Yes.
Now, I'm the wife who is not doing what I'm supposed to do.
No. Yes. before you move forward? Can't you go to the neighbor? Does it have to be my sister, my blood?
Let me put it this way.
Yes.
I'm the wife who's a corporate wife. Mm-hmm. Now, leave alone this thing you're talking about that someone has gone to, is a new mother, she's yes. given birth, yes. she's... I am the corporate mother.
Yes.
Who is going to work at 6.
Yes.
I leave husband in the bed.
Yes.
And I want to go to work because yes. I need to please my bosses.
Yes.
That's one.
Yes.
Husband is self-employed.
Yes.
Judithiana, you're the cashier.
Yes.
Yeah?
Yes.
Have you opened the shop? Yes.
Yes.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. He's in the bed.
Mm.
At home with the maid.
Oh.
Okay.
With the little sister. Yeah.
My little sister.
Oh, okay.
Now, me, I've gone to work to please my boss. Mm. I've left my other boss in bed.
Yes.
And I think that sister will take care of all the omelettes and all that.
Yes.
I am going to look insufficient to this man, and he is going to try and please himself. I mean, it's a cold morning. I've driven out in the rain. The guy is feeling cold. Mm.
Oh, no. No longer. Hold up. Hold up, please. Question. Because, yes. Also, I feel sorry for you. It's a cold morning. Hey, listen, I'm feeling sorry for you, mom. It's a cold morning. Yeah? We've left you in bed. I've gone to please my boss. Listen, can't you at least use Pamela? Yes, Pamela. No, listen, yes, because...
Fine. Now, this little sister feels that my big sister brought me into this, mm-hmm. and mwami jango bere na fe, o mwami aja kusasulira school fees.
Oh, yes, mwami yasasula school fees. The husband pays.
Yeah? So she also would want to please this man. And the man, you know, let me tell you, these men...
She wants to
pull. Let me say this in Luganda.
Yes.
E joli fumba blunji nono kusinga mkulu wo.
Translation! Translation!
You make this omelette so good.
It's tastier than what your bigger sister.
Hmm? You're so neat. Hmm? Then me, as a winning mother, I'm putting on this as if overall nighty up to the knees. I mean up to
like a monk, a sister of some sort in a convent.
Yes. And this girl will put on her up to the knees what? Maybe dress, maybe skirt and what? And it's all enticing to this man in this cold weather.
Cold weather, but this, let's not forget that this is still your little sister, your blood.
Yes.
If he really wants to help himself, he can go and get a Judithiana at his work place.
Yes.
Yes.
And now this man, this man is in that situation. The compliments will come in one after the other, and for you, I left you 20,000. How did you spend this money? And then say, hey, kale ogenda okole kumviri, and he leaves there 20,000.
The man.
What do you expect?
I mean, she'll have come to pay the money.
Come on. Okay, Nalong, let me ask you a very difficult question. If now let's be realistic, you get your man with your little.
I'll beat the hell out of her.
You beat her?
Yes.
Not the man?
I'll beat them both.
Look at the way you're dressed. You've come to my place. I'm your big sister.
Uh-huh.
My husband, Lord Bitum, is there.
Seeing you loitering around.
Yeah, seeing you loitering
moving,
around.
Moving. How do you expect him to do?
Okay, we're going to get into that when we come back. Remember, if you want to be a part of this situation, we want to solve the situation. This is something that happens in our society each and every day. And usually men walk scot-free. Apparently, you don't blame the man. You blame the little sister because she wore a little skirt. Do you expect her to wear a Gomez? She's 13 or she's 16 for crying out loud. Huh? Can we stop blaming the dress code of the little sister? Huh? This situation needs to be solved. If you want to be a part of the conversation, hashtag is Saloon Talk. However, J&J Saloon & Spa has a Facebook page. If you want to make bookings to come in on a Sunday, Saturday, we work 7 days a week. Go to our Facebook page, J&J Saloon & Spa, and ask your questions away. My name is Judith Yana. Saloon Talk. We'll be right back.
Saloon Talk is brought to you by...
You are confident. You are radiant. Look good, feel great.